I believe we can all enjoy watching butterflies outside because they're like the eye candy of nature. Got a smartphone? I can tell you how to identify whatever species of butterfly you come across in seconds with some free and fancy technology. So even if you can't identify a single species of butterfly right now, with this app you could be a butterfly whiz to your kids, to your spouse, to your dog, to whoever. And this is a super good year to find butterflies. I also want to see some of your photos of butterflies. Yes, I will feature them in an upcoming episode. So stick around to learn more about that and how to identify butterflies. What's up, nature admirer? I am Koaw, and this is another Casual Outdoors Weekly where we go over an outdoors activity for you to do for the benefit of your health and happiness. We also knock up our nature smarts a bit, all under 6 minutes. I hope to see you next week, so be subscribed if you're not. And this week's casual outdoors activity is to identify a butterfly. We are indeed after insects in the order Lepidoptera, which includes over 180,000 species of butterflies and moths, where butterflies only make up about 11%-ish of that order. So although there is no hard and fast rule to distinguish a butterfly from a moth, there are some general guidelines I can tell you about. Butterflies will usually be active during the day, and moths more active at night. Butterflies tend to be more colorful. They're larger, and they fold their wings vertically over their body, whereas moths tend to fold their wings down like a tent covering their abdomen. But like I said, there are exceptions to all of those rules. So the first step to identifying a butterfly is actually finding one, and you'll find different types of butterflies in differing habitats. Check your local gardens, or the woods, alongside creeks and rivers, at lakefronts, in a meadow, and even in forest clearings. The butterflies that we are after today are in their adult form. You know, they're no longer chubby and or hairy larvae because now they have wings. So this means we're going after butterflies that have two primary objectives: obtain sustenance to survive, like water, nectar, and minerals, so that they can eventually accomplish their ultimate goal, reproduce. So before you step outside to ID a butterfly, download the free app INaturals, which you can get from your app store, or just go to inaturalist.org to make sure you get the safe link to the app. This is a citizen scientist naturalist website, and I love it. And then you'll need to set up a free account. So when you have the app on your phone, and you know how to access it on your computer, which I prefer to use, all you need is a photo of a butterfly. So get outside and find some butterflies. So you can take the photo in real time right from the app, from your smartphone while you're outside, or you can choose an image from your phone, or you can even upload one from your computer to the web version. And within seconds, their software will give a top suggestion to what you've seen. And better yet, other people will view your observation to confirm your identification or suggest perhaps it's something else. It's super simple, and guess what? You can do this with any species, including plants. And I prefer using the desktop, the web version, because it offers more features and is a little bit easier to use, but the app on your phone is an awesome field tool, so I highly recommend you use that too. All right, I'm gonna rate this activity at super chill, and it was absolutely free. So that's always a plus. All right, so nature is nifty. So I found a beautiful red-spotted purple the other day, which is also a Bayesian mimic, which means it is a harmless edible species that mimics the appearance of a toxic non-palatable species, which in this case is the pipe vine swallowtail. It's an example of convergent evolution, where certain traits of different species evolve to be similar in a particular environment, where in this case, certain predators of insects co-evolved along the toxic pipe vine swallowtail, developing an inherent knowing not to eat the pipe vine swallowtail because it's toxic. So this toxic species shared similar niches with populations of the red-spotted purple. And red-spotted purples that appeared more like the toxic pipe vine swallowtail were more likely to survive and reproduce, as would-be predators had an inherent warning system not to eat butterflies that resembled the toxic species, thus passing on those similar traits into future generations of the populations. So I want you guys to get outside with your kids or your spouse or whatever and take some photos of butterflies, and I want to see them. They don't have to be the best quality ever. I just want to know that this video convinced someone to go take a photo of a butterfly. And I'll feature it in an upcoming Casual Outdoors Weekly. So you can do that by posting your observation on iNaturalist, then giving that link down in the comments below. Or if you Instagram and you want to put it on Instagram, just tag at @KoawNature. Or if you Facebook, you can tag me at @KoawNature. So, get out there and do it. Spread some knowledge. Be nature heroic. I'll see you next week. Thanks for watching.